I've been coding almost exclusively only in C++ for 10 years now. And today I will teach you the real learning pitfalls that are out there. Not just surface things like don't use that IDE or read your documentation. I have 4 impact tips from absolute beginners to advanced, starting with how to actually learn the language. When I started coding, I was less than 14 years old, and I tried to learn C++ from everywhere possible. YouTube tutorials, mobile apps. I even attended an expensive programming course in my city. What I discovered is that they are all the exact same thing. So, whenever someone asks me what the first step in learning to code is, I always answer, just pick any tutorial that you like online. No expensive programming courses when it comes to the language basics. They all teach the exact same thing as a free YouTube video. I link down below the C++ tutorial I used to start learning. And no, you don't need to be good at math or other things. I was only 6th grade when I started, so no excuses. After you watch this video, I want you to just click that link and start learning C++. But not before I talk about the biggest pitfall there is while learning C++, and that is what to do after you learn the basics. To show you how important this is, I have an example. In high school, all they teach children is algorithms, which, by the way, 99% of them I never use. I, on the other hand, made Minecraft in C++ by the end of high school, so you decide what learning method is better. After I went to the basic YouTube tutorial, I of course wanted to learn more, so I followed more and more tutorials. But for some reason, I wasn't really finding more information. I don't know why, but it's really hard to find advanced C++ things in courses or tutorials. Even the very expensive paid course I attended only showed the C++ basics. If you search for an advanced C++ course online, still only beginner or intermediate things, like how are these things here advanced C++? But when I went to university, everyone told me the C++ course was extremely hard, and I was really excited. Could this be the moment I finally learned new advanced things? What did I learn there? Nothing. I already knew everything, because guess what? They only showed basics and some intermediate things that people call advanced. So, is there any way to learn more advanced C++? Yes, there is, and I'll show you how. But that's not actually what you want to spend your time on. Learning the language is not the same thing as learning how to code. Imagine you have a car, and you learned all the possible theory about how to correctly shift the gears, and make turns, and all of that stuff. But you almost never practice driving it. That's not how you would learn to drive, is it? For C++, it's the exact same thing. You want to learn how to code, not just how to use the C++ language. That will only get you to write weird code, instead of doing something useful. So once you understand some basics, focus on writing code, rather than learning more C++. You have to make projects, big projects. Let me give you examples. Simon Says was the first little game I made in C++, and it looks something like this. Then, I made a simple Five Nights at Freddy's game, and it looks something like this. The thing to remember is to choose a project that is just a little difficult for you. If you want to improve, you need to challenge yourself with harder and harder projects. Start with a 100-line project, then 300, then 1000, and so on. Pick something that you find interesting, something that relates to your other hobbies. If you like games, just make a C++ game, because that's more enjoyable to you. And hello, subscribe to this channel. Like, did you read the channel name? It's low-level game dev. And also, this guy has the coolest simple C++ project tutorials on YouTube. You have to check him out for project ideas. Now, the last pitfall is extremely important, because without knowing about it, you can get stuck for the rest of your life writing horrible code. And for some reason, many people don't agree with my point, but it's just so simple and logical. The C++ language is the first modern language as we know programming today. People still use it heavily, and it's been around for 40 years. C++ was the first to introduce templates, and while not the first to introduce polymorphism, it was definitely the first modern language to have them. And you know how the first time you do something, it doesn't turn out that great? Well, that's the case with C++. Also, Casey Muratory said something very interesting that is related to the previous point I made in the video. So, he says that most people in the C++ committee don't spend much time working on big projects, but rather, theorizing what features would be good to add to the language. And I really agree with him. A lot of C++ features just feel awfully designed and are annoying to use. And if I take my biggest project ever, which is this multiplayer Minecraft game, I never use most C++ features, simply because I didn't need them. And it's not just because I'm a rebel or anything. Let's take smart pointers for example. They have their uses for sure, but as big as this game is, I didn't need them. In fact, I didn't need to think about memory management almost at all. Check out this video if you want more details. But the idea is, whenever you code, you just have to keep things simple. Of course you should know about C++ features, so I will give you some tips to learn them at the end of the video. But I always tell people that I write most of my C++ code, like this C. I just use only some C++ features most of the time. Usually, they reply that why don't I just write it in C, or that I should write C++ properly. But to me, those comments don't make any sense. Like, C++ has some good features and some bad features. I just use the features that are good for the task. Why should I use exceptions if they come with a ton of problems and they don't help me in the first place? Like, I can just return false if a function fails. And while this is the most rudimentary error system possible, I just happen to not need anything more. Or why should I switch to C when there are some C++ features that are very good and that I use all the time that I don't want to give up? Okay, let's see what some of those features are. Templates. While they are very useful in C++, they are incredibly hard to get right sometimes. If you want to implement a template container that manages some memory, like a vector, there are so many weird rules and things, and I can never get it right. So don't spam templates all over your code. In fact, you actually don't need them 99% of the time. Just use the containers already implemented by C++, and you are good to go. If you make a big project, you already have a lot to think about. I don't want to add extra language complexity for no reason. So whenever I code, I just write very simple, plain C++ code that's easy to read, understand, and debug. Like, what's the point in writing code that looks like this? I don't even know what this does. And you know what? I don't even care. C++ is made to make projects with it, not show off who can write the most obscure code. Also, stay away from OOP. While it may be used by many people to help them work in a team, it will only harm your projects. Just write very simple code that gets the job done. Don't overthink it. And then, after it is working, if you need to, improve it. I know many people would disagree with tips like this. But then, look at this example. So this is Casey Muratory, and I learned this programming advice from his YouTube videos. One time, he complained that the Microsoft console was terribly slow. Like, it just renders some simple text. It has no reason to be slow. In fact, he argued, you don't even need to optimize it. It should just be fast by itself. Microsoft responded that it would be too hard for an effort to optimize it. So what did Casey do? He implemented a console from scratch in like 2 days, with more features, and he didn't even optimize it. But yet, it was faster and better than the one from Microsoft. Like, he just wrote some simple code over the weekend, and it turned out better than what Microsoft has been working at for the past years or so. I don't know about you, but I want to be more like this guy here. And if you also want that, you should watch these videos from him. He has this series on YouTube called Handmade Hero, where he makes a game in C++ from scratch. If you are into C++ game dev, you should 100% watch as many of his videos as you can. I know they are difficult. But as of now, I don't really know a better place to learn good programming practices. I will release a Game Dev C++ course in the future, where I also talk about good programming practices, so it is linked down below if it is out. Now, where to learn the advanced C++ things from? Unfortunately, I wasn't able to find them all in one place. Like, I had to learn them from various different YouTube tutorials that were not that easy to find. So I made a list with all of them myself. On my Discord server, I have some resources channels, where I placed all of the very good tutorials I use to learn various programming things, including C++. So now go in the description and click the link that you need to start or continue your C++ journey. I don't care what's your excuse, do it now. See you there.